Due to the iterative nature of the design process, there are many versions of the actual project which have to be continuously managed. Several versions of the project are published due to the number of revisions. These changes have to be documented, the affected layouts have to be selected and marked, and subsequently, the published documentation has to be updated. ARCHICAD supports the traditional drawing and layout-based revisioning, which includes visual highlights, revision clouds, and also introduces a new BIM-based revisioning, where the focus is on being able to find the layouts that were affected by the changes of the project, therefore making the whole documentation process easier. Let's see how revisioning works. You may continue working on the current project, or open the TS03 Chapter 10 PLN ARCHICAD Solo project file to complete this chapter of the training series. If the library manager appears and informs you that the training textures are unavailable, then click the Add button at the bottom of the dialog. Select the Training Textures folder. This is located in the Training Files folder of the downloaded guide. Click Choose to add this folder, and then click OK to proceed. Before we can start marking the changed elements and highlight the changes, we have to create our very first issue, which will contain the whole documentation set at its current state. The revised versions will be collected from this point. We will use a special palette for most of the revision management related task called the Change Manager. Open the Change Manager using the Project Chooser button at the top left of the navigator. The top part of the palette will show the changes, while the bottom will collect the elements that are related to those specific changes. Click the Issue History button. The Book Settings dialog opens. Click New Issue. Enter the name Schematic Design in the Name field. Click OK. The first issue is created containing all the layouts of the layout book, marked in blue. Later, all the changed layouts will be marked like this for easier identification. Click Close Issue. And click OK to close the dialog. Now we can start highlighting the noteworthy changes of the project. The entrance area currently has the pavement from outside as a floor slab. This will change now, and we'll highlight the change. Open the ground floor view in the view map of the navigator, and zoom into the entrance area. Select the slab tool in the toolbox. Select the pavement slab. Click an edge of the selected slab, and select the Subtract from Polygon option on the PET palette. Subtract the entrance area part from the pavement slab as presented on the screen. Click the edge of the selected slab again, and select Curve Edge option on the PET palette. Adjust the pavement slab to the internal edge of the curved wall. Now select the internal floor slab and extend it using the PET palette. First, use the Add to Polygon option. Then use the Curve Edge option. We're now ready to mark the changes. This change needs a visual highlight as well, so let's add a revision cloud also. Select the Change tool in the toolbox and open its Settings dialog. Display the General panel and enter Slab in the Change Name field. Display the Marker panel. Enter 20 into the Pen Color field. This will change the pen to red. Display the marker symbol and text panel. Select the circle marker head option. Click OK to apply all changes and to close the dialog. Draw the revision cloud around the changed area. Place the change marker. The change will automatically appear in the Change Manager. Select the change entry in the Changes panel of the Change Manager palette. We can see that currently there is only one element linked to it, and this is the cloud object we have just placed on the ground floor. Having the change selected in the Change Manager palette, select the modified slab on the floor plan. Click the Link Selection to Change icon on the Change Manager palette. Notice that now the slab element is also displayed in the Elements of Change 1 panel.